This song, Open Up the Heavens, was a song that was born in community and written in community. I love that. And it's a song that was started by Jason Ingram, Stu G, and I. It's a great privilege to write with those guys. And so we got together in a room. Stu brought this amazing hook that he wanted to write a song on. And we started just pouring out lyrics on this song. There's that psalm in Psalm 22:3 that says, the Lord is enthroned on the praises of Israel. And often worship leaders and people have interpreted that as the Lord inhabits the praises of his people, which is true. He does inhabit the praises of his people. And so we started singing that out, you know, and we started talking about a song that would gather people to worship him, you know, so that we could set up that verse, you know, that he inhabits our praises. And that was where the lyric, we've waited for this day, we're gathered in your name, we're calling out to you. It's a great song to just start off a worship set with. So we landed that version of the song, and then we brought it back to Harvest. And our senior pastor, James, who's written some lyrics with us before, I got together with him, and he'd been in the book of Exodus, and there's these verses in chapter 34, you know, where the presence of the Lord appears as a cloud to Moses. And it says, the Lord descended in a cloud and stood with him there and proclaimed the name of the Lord. The Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord, a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, keeping steadfast love for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin. So we went at it with that verses, and James was pouring all these other verses into it, and that was how verse 2 came around. So now we have version 2 of the song that we've pulled James into, and Jason was in town leading worship. Jason's been leading worship at our church for maybe 8 or 9 years. You know, he comes in once in a while, leads our church, so they know him. And he was standing on stage with myself and Meredith, and Jacob was there. And in our morning service, we just decided in the rehearsal, hey, let's play that song. Let's see how it sounds like with a band. We haven't heard it with a band yet. And there was this beautiful moment where Jason turns to Meredith, and we hadn't written a bridge yet. And so we just kind of went into a bridge shape musically, you know, and Jason turns to Meredith and says, just sing, Meredith, just sing out whatever comes. I will never forget that moment, because you just, right out of your mouth, and I love this about you, Meredith, just like it just flows right out of you, you just encapsulated that whole song by singing the lyric, show us your glory, Show us your power, show us your glory, Lord. And that was the song coming together. And then we took it, so we played it that morning to our church just to kind of get a read on it, you know. They all clapped and roared. And then we took it to the cathedral for the recording night. And at the end of the night, when we played through all the songs, we ended up going back to the bridge of that song, show us your glory. And I'm so glad that made it to the record, because that was a real unplanned moment in the night. You know, none of us knew where it was going, but it ended up being almost like the lyric that is the banner over the whole record. You know, what we're asking for the Lord, for him to descend like a cloud, yeah, for him to show us his glory and his presence in this place, so that he would inhabit the praises of his people. Yeah. You know, as we sing to him, show us, Lord, show us your glory.
It's a banner over this record, but I really believe it's a banner over our church.
Right.
Like, even in the last year, I remember, you know, when James started preaching through Exodus, and like, I remember when he preached on that passage,
yeah,
and I remember when he was talking about the church getting back to being the church where everything is just about God's glory,
yeah,
and we want to see God's glory, and that's why we exist, and that's what we're about. And it's not about the methods and the programs and the little things, like all those are well and good, but we've got to keep the main thing.
Amen.
And that is bringing glory to the Lord and seeking his glory. And so for us to be able to sing that, and
yeah,
like you said, kind of bookend the record, like that is the banner for our church and the thing that we want to sing to God, like, because we'll never run out of glory, like God's glory, you know. We'll never like get to the place where, like, okay, well, we've come to the end of your glory, so we'll just camp out here for a bit.
Right.
Like, we're always like that's there's no end to who God is,
yeah,
and the glory that, like, it surrounds him. And so to keep that as the cry of our hearts always, and just say, God, show us your glory, show us your power, demonstrate your power, and show up big and strong on behalf of your people. That's our cry.
That's great. That's how I open up the heavens, came about power.